Greetings, everyone, and welcome to TELEVERSE Reviews Live. I am your host, ALANNIS Maximus. Whichever fucking way I point, this is my co-host, TOMYE West. I'm never going to get that right.
Howdy, y'all. Howdy, y'all.
And we are both annoyed at life, but not at the moment, because we're reviewing Beavis and Butt-Head Season 2. Not the first Season 2, the new Season 2, Episode 4. Which is nice and confusing for all of you. And this episode was a banger.
Definitely was. It was definitely a banger. I mean, like, take a bow.
Yes. I am the vassal of that episode, and I say,
take a bow. What a great fucking 2-episode.
Oh, man, I just got what you meant.
Yeah, man. Come on, man. Be with it, you know? Come on. Yeah, no, like, take a bow, bro, you know? So, I mean, this fucking episode, man, like, both were really great episodes, but I'm going to have to just put it straight out there and say the second episode in this episode, as we know it's broken up into 2 episodes, is the best, like, so far in my books. I mean, it just impressed me on so many different levels, which we'll talk about in a minute, but I just wanted to give my overarching sort of like initial impression, you know what I mean? So, I mean, what did you think about both? How did you feel about Hellhole and then Take a Bow?
I think it was very well planned out as well, in like how it was kind of juxtaposed. Like, Hellhole was one of those really outlandish slapstick episodes where they should have been dead, but not dead.
Yep.
And then Take a Bow was one of those ones where one of them almost did die. It was weird how they played off against each other there.
Yeah, it was really good. It was really good. I mean, we have some clips that we're going to try and run without getting fucking dinged with copyright laws, but hey. I think it's worth bringing this up. Let's take a quick look at the setup for not Hellhole, but let's take a quick look at the setup for Take a Bow, because I think it's something that is just great. One second here. Share screen. Window. All right. Pray to the copyright law people that we can do 15-second clips without getting our fucking asses handed to us, yeah?
Beavis really hurt his testicles or something, and I think he needs some pills, like stat or something.
We'll have a doctor take a look. Has he been in pain long?
Not really. Maybe a week?
So, that's one clip from Beavis and Butt-Head Take a Bow, and because we have to play in breaks, obviously. Now let's try and see how this goes if we play this. Here we go.
Oh my gosh, what happened?
We don't really know.
You better check this out.
All right, so another break for a second, guys.
So that was cool, Beavis. Take a bow.
What?
So this is where we get the setup for what's happened through his testicles.
Take a bow.
So that, if we skip forward a little bit, we will see that.
Get out. Take a bow.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah. Yeah, I get it now. Yeah.
Well, you're a good sport for playing.
Yeah, thanks.
Take a bow.
And then the last bit I wanted to show from this little bit was what he says to the nurse when that cuts back to them.
Take a bow. Take a bow.
Cut it out.
Take a bow.
Stop.
Take a bow. It is a mystery.
So, I mean, that's the setup for it. We're going to bring up another clip later on that when we talk about the section that I want to talk about. But Alanis, first of all, give me your impressions on Hellhole.
I liked it. It was one of those ones that is on just the stupider level of things. The whole premise of they fall down there, they think they've gone to hell. And I think my favorite part is when they start using the pneumatic drill on the gas line and blow themselves to kingdom come. And then the scene where they're coming down, they think they're seeing an angel coming down the manhole. Yeah, dude is like, you boys are alive.
I just love that. I think we're at Satan's apartment. It's the sanitation department. But yeah, like, I definitely thought it was a good episode, like a good part to this episode, but I didn't think it had anything on Take a Bow. I think Take a Bow just levels it up. What did you think of Take a Bow?
I liked it. It was a very, very simple episode, but it also, one big thing I noticed is it developed. We talk a bit and have talked a bit in the previous episodes about Beavis having a bit more depth and a bit more development, where this shows a bit of development from Butthead. For like the first time ever, he kind of gives a fuck about Beavis.
And that's my main draw to this episode and why it's so fantastic, is because, like, we said a bunch of times that, like, Beavis sort of has this, like, thing where he's, like, following Butthead's sort of, like, commands and, like, doesn't get the whole idea of, like, the consequences that he's going to face after doing it. They both of them don't think about the consequences, but Butthead's usually the enforcer or the driver of those consequences possibly happening because they're usually his idea. I mean, we kind of see little things from Beavis where he's, like, talking, like, where he'll come up with something, but it's very, like, it's not that bad, like how he threw the Slurpee on top of the roof just then, you know what I mean? Like, check that out. You know, nothing major, where Butthead's like, pick up the gun and shoot, you know? Like, we always talked about how there was like this depth to Beavis where he was like in touch with his feelings but didn't show it because of Butthead. And like, as much as they are sort of the same character, like the yin and the yang of each other, they definitely do have their differences. And that's what I found so refreshing about this episode, was the fact that Butthead, we got to see a different side of Butthead that we hadn't seen before, you know what I mean? And it was really like, kind of, it was funny, but it was also very touching, you know what I mean? So what I'm going to do is, now that we're up to what I was wanting to talk about, is let's see that development of Butthead if we can. Oh, and by the way, dude, I was fucking dying at the part when he's standing there and he's talking to Beavis at the hospital bed, and then that dude in behind, he's like, shut up, I'm trying to sleep. And then Butthead just goes, shut up, dumbass. I fucking lost my shit, bro. And then he's just like, if I could come back there or whatever, I'd make you take a bow. This is that scene right here. So we're going to bring it up again. We will have to play it in sections. Hopefully we don't get stung. Here we go.
Keep it down. I'm trying to sleep.
Shut up, butt munch. This guy's balls are all messed up. If this wasn't a hospital, I'd make you take a bow. Beavis, did you hear what I just said to that guy?
So that is what. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hold on one second. One second. Let me pause this. So I'm gonna bring that up again in a minute, and we're gonna see how we got Butthead sort of showing a little softer side to him. All right, let's show that now.
Beavis. Whoa. I think I killed him.
Now, another little break for a second, Alanis, and then let's try and skip forward a little bit to here.
It's like, I didn't mean to hurt him. Feeling bad sucks.
So now we're going to skip to when he goes into the chapel. And this is the part that I really actually found funny, like hilariously funny, at the same time touching. And that's what I loved about this episode. Here we go.
Dear Heavenly Lord God, Father Jesus Christ Almighty, please don't let Beavis die. He still has, like, work to do here on Earth or something. Work sucks.
So we'll pause it there for a second, and then we'll continue on with this last little bit of his sort of prayer, and we'll go from there.
Please heal the pain in his broken gnats. Cradle them gently in your giant holy hand. I didn't mean to put him in the hospital. It was just like, cool.
And then we'll finish up here with this.
I mean, it was funny, right? Like, take a bow. That was cool.
And then we will skip forward a bit to where the sort of last touching moment between Beavis and Butt-Head here in this episode, which I really, really did find funny and touching. So,
Butt-Head, I'm me. I was wondering, like, I'm me. You think it would be cool?
Oh, yeah. Huh.
To do it with an octopus?
No.
Yeah, me neither. Yeah, I don't know why I said that.
Now.
Beavis, I'd probably laugh about it eventually, but it would have sucked if I killed you by hitting your nuts.
No, really? Thanks, buddy.
So I really, really thought that that was, like, not only hilarious, but touching. And I thought, wow, we're seeing a side to Butt-Head that we haven't seen. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And that is what made this episode something special for me, which is, like, we got more layers. You know what I mean? We didn't just get the Beavis and Butt-Head that we normally get. We got layers. And while me and you were talking about this previously to coming, like, you know, live stream, like talking about it on our Facebook and giving it our scores so we could get the, you know, scoreboard together, I was like, you know, as you said, you really liked the werewolf episode from 2011. It's episode one, 2011. And that's the episode where they go see Twilight and they realize that all these chicks love fucking vampires and all this shit and they want to become werewolves or whatever. And then they get bitten by the homeless dude. And then they're like lying on the fucking sofa, like with old bed sores all over them, and they look like shit. And then he's just like, well, time to go get some girls. And then, so, like, I know we were talking about how you really liked that episode, and I agree. I reckon that's probably one of the top five episodes ever made of Beavis and Butt-Head. But it didn't have that level of hilarity that we got from Take a Bow on this one, as well as those moments of sort of, you know, touching, you know?
Yeah. So would you say this is your favorite Beavis and Butt-Head episode?
Oh, ever? Like, are you talking ever? See, that's hard, man, because I have some classics from back in the day. Do you remember the episodes? Do you remember the episode where they shave off their hair to, like, put it on their beard?
Yeah. Even my beard has hands.
That is, like, one of my all-time favorite episodes of Beavis and Butt-Head, when they're just, like, their hair looks all like, oh, they've got like all the shaved spots like all randomly, and then they just got like the, it looks so fucking funny. And I really love the one, the sex education one.
Yes.
Do you remember that, where the gym teacher is being like, we're going to talk about the testicles, we're going to talk about the scrub, like, and you're just like, Butt-Head's like, and then they like hold on to their laughter all day, and then they get out of luck school, and they're like, it just can't stop laughing. That's what they're like, my favorite. That, the werewolf one. I really also like the going down.
That's familiar.
That's in 2011, where they're in the elevator and they keep pressing the button because it says going down. And I also really like the telemarketer episode.
Ah, yes, yes.
Where they're in the telemarketing thing and he's just like, the guy's like, hello, my name is Hamid. And then Beavis is like, listening to him, and he's like, hello, my name is Hamid. So, how would you put these against previous episodes? Like, I mean, in your sort of like, would you put this as like one of your top moments for Beavis and Butt-Head, like in your top five? Or would you say?
I'll put it in my top five. I think the Wales episode just tickled me in the right ways that I think that off the top of my head, it's been a long time since I've watched a lot of the early episodes, but clear in my mind, that's still my favorite episode, but this one is definitely a contender.
Definitely, definitely. I have to agree, man. I have to definitely agree. I'm about to do something that I have not done on Televerse reviews yet, as you know.
Yes, and we should get onto that, do you reckon?
We definitely should. Let's talk about it now.
Well, so, what we do, I didn't say it earlier, but on this series, what we do is we ultimately give each episode of a season a score out of 100, but we do it a little different. I give it a score of 0 to 50. Tomye gives it a score out of 0 to 50. We add them together, and that is the total score. So
it's usually, you know, whatever out of 100, 78, 80, whatever out of 100 when we put our scores together. So it's a 100-point scale, you know what I mean? So with that, let's bring up the tally. Are we ready for this?
Yes. Yes.
Now, this is actually, before we rank, before we bring out the board of like the overall thing, let's talk about the score of this week and why we gave it that score.
I am giving this one a very sizzling 48.
Wow, I thought you said 47, yeah?
Yeah.
And then you changed it to 48. So you're 2 points away from a perfect episode. That's pretty crazy, man. That's pretty crazy. I wonder if, like, the general public will feel the same way about these episodes as us, because I think if you're looking for, like, just your classic Beavis and Butthead, like, this has still got it all in there. But I almost feel like this has got a lot more to it that maybe some people may not appreciate, or they might appreciate it. I don't know. How do you feel about that assumption?
I definitely think so. I think some people might be like, oh, you're giving them depth, which, good.
Good.
They've done as far as they can really go without doing that, I think.
Yeah, I think they need to start adding depth and showing you who they really are and showing like a softer side or a different side or whatever. You know what I mean? It's kind of like the episode where Butthead takes the ADD medication.
Yes.
That was a great episode too, you know what I mean? So with that, my score for this episode being so strong and so good and like showing so much depth to the characters and everything, I'm going to give this a fat 50.
Dun, 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 dun. 50
out of 50, making this episode a 98 out of 100. And the scoreboard looks a little like this, or sounds a little like this, depending on how you are viewing / listening to this. Episode 4, which is the one we currently reviewed, sitting at number 1 with a 98. Episode 3, last week's, sitting at a 92 at number 2. Episode 2, sitting at an 89. So that's 3 on the chart. And then episode 1 with a 77 at number 4. Now, that's very interesting if you ask me, Alanis, because I almost felt like, do you think that they're maybe holding like these sorts of caliber episodes for like the season to like get better and better as we go? Because I'm very surprised that we did not get like this sort of strength episode to begin with the season. What do you think?
It's interesting that it's getting better and better. And it's also going to be interesting to see where it goes from here. Like if we're going to see a divot, is it going to get lower? Are we going to plateau at just greatness? I'm interested, but it definitely feels like they've been a bit progressive in how they've ordered it in terms of quality.
I definitely agree, and I think that this was one of the best episodes yet, and I can't wait for the next episode, you know. And hopefully, man, we can get this episode out without any copyright things, because I think I did a pretty good job there breaking it up, you know what I mean? Like, it was more reactionary than it was just like blatantly playing it. You know what I mean? So
You should take a bow.
Yeah, definitely. if you were there, I'm sure. If you were here with me, I'm sure you'd hit me in the nuts. But like, dude, I'd be bummed if this gets copyright dinged. If it does, I'll have to cut some stuff out, because I've noticed that if we just get one copyright ding, our fucking episode just YouTube want none of it. Because they can't make the revenue, which is fair enough, I guess. Dogs.
Yeah.
Dog. So, I mean, let's wrap this up, Alanis. Is there anything you want to say as we wrap up?
Absolutely not. I don't have much to add at this point. I'm very much looking forward to the next episode.
Me too. And, like, what have we got coming up next for Ranked and Reviewed?
We have, obviously, more of this. We have... What is our next big one? Our next Fast and the Furious X, I think.
Yeah, unfortunately, I think you're right. That
next week, Thursday next week.
Unfortunately, I think you're correct, Alanis, and fuck me, man. Like, I have not seen a Fast and the Furious movie since Tokyo Drift. Yeah, like, I may have seen Fast and the Furious 4. I have a feeling I remember something. Is it, like, them, like, trying to get, like, VCR TV things out of the truck? Or is that, like, the first one or the second one? Like, Too Fast, Too Furious?
That'll be the second one, I think.
Yeah, man, that's as far as... And Tokyo Drift, I thought, was just, like, completely shit.
I liked Hobbs and Shaw. That was pretty much just... That was an action movie that was just under the banner of Fast and the Furious.
I haven't seen it. And also, let's quickly discuss to everyone the quick change we've made to Ranked and Reviewed before we head out. Now,
yes,
Ranked and Reviewed has always been a show about us ranking movies compared to each other, like next to each other in a franchise. So it'll be like, you know, Halloween 1, Halloween 2, Halloween 3. And we'll go week by week talking about each Halloween movie and putting them from him ranked like best to worst or worst to best, whichever you want to go for. And we've decided that Ranked and Reviewed is going to take a little bit of a different twist this year. And that is going to be the fact that we're going to review every movie that we see this year and rank them in a list of worst to best for the entire year. So, like, every episode we're going to add onto that list, and you're going to eventually, at the end of this year, have a complete ranking of every movie this year, like, from best to worst that we go see, like, you know, that we cover. It'll be, like, streaming movies, like, video, you know, going to the cinemas, like, any new releases that we do in this calendar year. And I think that it should be from, like, a December to December basis, yeah? Because I would love to include Avatar 2 as, like, sort of the starting grounds of where this year kind of began, you know what I mean? So yeah. What me and you need to do is we need to discuss what we're going to do about the rankings so far. And what I wanted to ask you quickly was, what do you think would be better? Do you think we should go fucking all in and make it we have to agree on one list, or do we do two separate lists? Because I think we can come up with a pretty average, like, by averages, a good list, one solid list, and we can, like, obviously talk to each other and understand where each other come from with your entries and my entries. And I'm more than willing to, like, be like, yeah, I get it. You liked Guardians of the Galaxy more than I did, but it probably definitely deserves to be sitting at this spot rather than where I think it should. You know what I mean? So, like, I think if we can have, like, a fair talk about it and shit, it'd be cooler if we, like, had it as one list, because that would be a little bit more interesting for the viewer and ourselves. What do you think?
I don't know. It'll be interesting. I think maybe even what we could also do is we could have our own list and then from that arrange it into a conjoined list.
Or we could do what we said is one complete list, right? And have our, like, lists off to the side and keep those as, like, well, this is what our personal list is, but this is what we came to an overall agreement with as well. You know what I mean? I mean, there's different ways we could do it. But what I want everyone to know is that the things that we have already ranked against other movies and franchises, such as Batman, Indiana Jones, any Scream movies that come out, any Halloween movies come out, they will still be ranked against the other entries in the franchise so that we can dust those off and say we've done those the way that we always intended on doing. But anything new from now on out is just going to be ranked as a whole yearly thing. And I think that sounds really cool. I think that's a lot more fun, and I think it's going to have a huge list at the end of the year and people can disagree or whatever. And maybe we can do, like, a whole episode where we talk about maybe, like, if we get it write-ins or something, maybe someone could tell us what they don't agree with and we can go into that and talk about that. You know what I mean? So
yeah,
this adds a whole new element. So everyone keep your eye out for our Fast X review next week. We will be seeing that in 4DX. So that will be premiering on Ranked and Reviewed Breaks the Fourth Wall, which is all dedicated to movies in 4DX and the experience we have seeing that movie in 4DX, as well as the movie itself. And obviously there is a major difference in 4DX experiences, as we've seen, compared from Super Mario to Guardians of the Galaxy already, you know? So that's going to be interesting, too, to bring that up on Ranked and Reviewed. And next week, obviously, Televerse Reviews keeps going with Beavis and Butthead till it finishes. And we will also be getting our Digman episodes reviewed and out as soon as possible, too. We'd like to apologize for the lack of content, the lack of keeping up with things. We've decided to put a hold on the Patreon, and that's simply because Alanis is looking for a house currently at the moment, and it's taking up a lot of his time, and he needs to get that done, and I totally understand that, you know. And my band's coming up with our launch, and not just my band, like, I've been having a lot of other mental health issues and things like that, which I'm trying to keep leveled and I'm trying to keep positive about, but we appreciate everyone's time, we appreciate everyone's patience, and just know that we've got a lot more content, we're not going anywhere, and Loud Media is still on the train track. So
yes.
All right, so
when I do move in, it's going to be a whole new...
Oh, dude, if you can get, like, that sort of, you know, setup you were talking about, I'd love it if we could make it a space that we can just... I can come to yours after with the movie's done, and we can just sit together and talk about it. Absolutely. Rather than over the internet, you know what I mean? Like, I'd love a space for us, you know what I mean? And obviously we can't afford to do that right now unless it's something that we can have, like, in our house, and I definitely don't have that, you know what I mean? So hopefully you can come across that. We can have, like, sort of our own setup space, and, like, that means we can get to work properly on Ranked and Reviewed Goes to Hell and things like that, you know, and bring things to, like, you know, life that we've really wanted to bring to life but haven't had the means to because of certain things getting in the way. So, again, we appreciate all of you, your patience. We love you all, and we hope you're enjoying the content, and thank you so much for joining us, as always. Anything you want to say before we head out? That's it?
Not really. I hope you guys look after yourselves and...
Take a bow. Thank you. That's Alannis Maximus. I'm Tomye West. Thank you for joining us on Televerse Review. See you next time.